update on a case that I covered in my 5 Cold Cases Arkansas video that was released in December of 2020. In a case that was draped in mystery and had very little detail, we finally have some updated information as to what allegedly happened to Angie and Mikey. Angela Mack Cox, also known as Angie, and her 4-year-old son, Thomas Ratu, who was known as Mikey, went missing from Salem, Arkansas. Mikey was originally reported missing on September 1st, 2002 by his father Thomas Ratu, but his mother Angie wasn't reported missing for another 2 years. The events leading up to this are very strange, but pretty much led up to one couple, Clarence and Barbara Crewson. On April 10th, 2002, Angie married James Cox, and over a month later, on May 29th, 2002, they were involved in an auto accident that had fatalities and led them to being hospitalized. James would tell Detective Dale Weaver that his brother Jeremy Cox picked up Angie and Mikey from the hospital and took them to Batesville, Missouri to visit her mom. They would then travel to Thayer, Missouri, where they would pick up Dale Crewson, who took them to Dale's brother's farm. This is where Angie would meet Clarence and Barbara Crewson and would start working for them on their farm. While the trio was traveling through Alton, Missouri, they would get pulled over and Jeremy would be arrested for being in possession of a stolen vehicle. Angie and Dale were not charged in any crime because they were unaware the vehicle they were in was stolen. It is assumed that the Crewsons picked them up from the police station and took them back to the farm. Barbara would say that while Angie was working on the farm, she decided to let her and her husband care for Mikey and even made arrangements for them to adopt him. She would even say that the adoption was made final and all three parties, Angie, Clarence, and Barbara, signed the documents. At this point, Angie would head to Chowchilla, California and get a job at a Burger King. However, she would change her mind about the adoption and inform the Crewsons, who were very unhappy about this. Nonetheless, they told Angie to come back and pick up Mikey. They sent her money twice for her return to Missouri, but she wouldn't come back until she received the second round of funds. Barbara would pick up Angie from a bus stop in Springfield, Missouri, and return with her to the farm. Barbara claimed that Angie spent the night, but by morning, she had left with Mikey and that someone came and picked them up. However, she says she never heard a vehicle show up at the house to take them. During this time, Angie's mother, Lorna Poole, had tried to get in touch with her, but was unable to. Suspiciously, when she contacted Clarence for help in contacting Angie, he told her that she and Mikey had been picked up by Jeremy Cox and left. He also informed her that him and Barbara would be adopting Mikey with permission from Angie. However, we know part of this story was a lie because Jeremy Cox was in prison at the time and could not have picked up Angie. So this makes them even more suspicious. Why would they lie about Angie getting picked up by Jeremy Cox? Between 2004 and 2005, Clarence and Barbara moved back to Virginia. In April 2021, Dale Weaver, the investigator in the case, asked the Virginia FBI to come and give Barbara Crewson a polygraph test. When she was asked if she knew what happened to Angie and Mikey, she claimed she didn't know, but the polygraph would reveal that she was lying. In the post-polygraph interview, when Barbara was presented with this, she confessed a horrible secret. She said that Clarence told her that he had done away with both Angie and Mikey and got rid of them in the furnace that was attached to the farmhouse. After Angie went missing, Clarence and Barbara would move out of the farmhouse and into a house in Alton, Missouri. This is when Clarence got rid of the furnace to destroy any remaining evidence. A motive was never given, but I would assume the reason for his actions was due to Angie going back on the adoption and her plans to take Mikey away. In 2004, Clarence was sentenced to 10 years in a Laredo, Texas federal prison for firearm violations. He was released in Texas on parole after serving only 8 years. On February 17, 2012, he was shot to death by William Henry Johnson at ATC Forwarding Agency. It's a sad end to a case, and while it might not be the justice we were hoping for, at least it is officially closed as of April 7, 2021.